And the numbers are not good when it comes to the number of people testing positive for COVID-19 in the state. DHEC is reporting 6,992 new infections today and 41 more South Carolinians have now lost their lives due to the virus. The percent positive rate rose to 32.7%. To break down those numbers, that means nearly one in every three COVID tests in our state is coming back positive.
And Richland County continues to be the hardest hit county in the state. DHEC is reporting 970 new infections in Richland County. Greenville and Charleston counties are not far behind, each with more than 770 cases. And in Lexington, 639 new daily infections are being reported today.
Governor McMaster is urging South Carolinians not to panic despite a rise in COVID cases and hospitalizations. News 19's Julia Kaufman joins us now live from the State House with the governor's plan on how health officials are reacting to these new numbers. Good evening, Julia.
Good evening, Darcy. Yeah, the governor's plan, as you mentioned, is to keep South Carolina open. He also doesn't want to issue any mandates of any kind or require schools or businesses to shut down. He stressed today that the state's doing fine, but state health leaders disagree.
But as far as our economy and as far as the safety of the people, we are in excellent shape.
Governor McMaster is keeping a positive outlook, saying South Carolina is doing much better with the COVID-19 pandemic than it was a year ago.
The hospitals are doing well. They are prepared. They were prepared a year ago. They're prepared now. And the numbers now, the occupancy rates in the hospitals are better and lower than they were then.
While slightly fewer hospital beds are taken up by COVID patients this winter surge compared to last year, there's been a recent spike in hospitalizations, and cases have reached an all-time high in South Carolina.
The number of adults and children being hospitalized and being admitted to ICUs is increasing.
State epidemiologist Dr. Linda Bell says the Omicron variant is causing more mild cases overall, but it's still overburdening hospitals and raising concern.
People are still dying from COVID. It doesn't matter what the variant is. What matters most is that these are preventable deaths. It is our public health duty to raise alerts for people to do more to help reduce disease spread.
McMaster and Bell recognize issues with COVID-19 testing and turnaround times for results. Dr. Bell says DHEC is working to reduce wait times and warns people to expect delays.
We have been assured by the Biden administration that a half a billion new tests are going to be distributed to the states, but DHEC cannot find out when or where they're going to arrive.
As an added burden to hospitals, the South Carolina Hospital Association tells me many are facing workforce shortages, which makes dealing with this increase in patients harder. And as for testing, Dr. Bell says DHEC is looking into expanding their free testing opportunities, but they're not sure yet if they have the staff to do so. Andrea, she's urging everyone to stay safe and get vaccinated.